Hey guys, CB Super. Today I'm going to show you how to add some fireworks to your night scene inside of DaVinci Resolve using the standalone version of Particle Illusion. Let's go ahead and jump in. So the very first thing that I'm going to do is I'm actually going to track this scene because as you notice, it moves from left to right. We definitely don't want these particles to drift off. Now this scene already has some fireworks, so we can use this as both the background plate and reference image. Let's go ahead and jump into Fusion really quickly, and we're just going to look for something that we can track. So I think I want my effect to take place over here where there isn't as many fireworks going up. I think I could probably track this building right here. There's a lot of contrast there. So in order to actually track it, I need to bring in a tracker. So what I'm going to use is shift space. I'm going to type in the word tracker, and I'm just going to bring in the point tracker. Hit add, and then plug in my footage into that tracker. I'm going to load it over here on the left, and I'm just going to grab this little green square. Might be red on yours. And I'm gonna drop it right over here on a contrasty point. This is probably a pretty good spot right here where the light meets the dark. I'm gonna make my box just a little bit smaller so it has a little bit less work to do, and my area of search is gonna also be a little bit less. One thing I'm noticing is that I actually am on frame 89, so ideally I would have tracked this from frame 0, but since I'm already here, all I gotta do is track to end over here on the left. All right, so I have all of this information that is already tracked out, and it looks pretty good. So I'm just going to disconnect the tracker, move it off to the side, put my media in over here on the left, and I'll keep my media out over here on the right. Let's go jump over to Particle Illusions and find ourselves a firework particle. So I'm just gonna type in firework. There is a ton of actual fireworks. Some of them, like this one, looks just terrible. I wouldn't probably ever use that, but some of them are actually pretty cool. Keep in mind that you can either recolor them here or you can recolor them inside of Fusion. All we really need to do is just find something that we actually like. So this one looks pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and double click on it and play it in here to see what it looks like. Looks pretty good. I don't really like that color, but that's okay. I can change that really easily. One thing I really wanna make sure that I pay attention to is that the particle lives and dies inside of the actual composition here. If it goes outside of the comp, the effect is gonna be ruined because we're gonna see some clipping. So as that looks pretty good, I'm gonna come up to render and I'm just gonna render this out. I'm going to just delete the last part of this and I'm just gonna put this on the desktop. I'm gonna go ahead and type in firework one, that's fine. And instead of the ProRes 422, I'm actually gonna use the straight alpha option. And the only other setting that I'm gonna change is this frame rate. I'm gonna change it from 30 frames per second to 24 frames per second to match my composition setting inside of DaVinci. Start render. It's gonna render pretty quickly. I'm gonna go ahead and jump directly over to DaVinci Resolve and open up my media pool and just wait for the render. All right, now it's all done. Let's go ahead and bring it in. I'm gonna go ahead and import this media and I'm gonna bring in my firework and I'm gonna drop it directly onto my node panel. So let's go ahead and take a look at this firework by itself. We'll see that it's a pretty good looking firework. We notice that it's already on transparency because we brought it in with that alpha. And if we wanna take a look at the alpha by itself, it's pretty simple. All we gotta do is click on the little alpha channel there and it's a fairly perfect alpha, which is really nice. It'll make it really easy when we actually want to recolor this. So let's go ahead and back to RGB mode and I'm going to take this media 2 and I'm gonna drop it on top of this media 1. Now I'm dropping it on the outputs so that it will automatically create a merge node, merging the firework on top of the actual background. I'm gonna take this media out and I'm going to drop it in on the right viewer so I can kind of keep an eye on it. Now let's say I wanna put this in at frame 40. Well, we'll notice that this effect took place within the first 10 frames or so. I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of this media pool for now. So I'm actually going to need to change the timing of my firework. And I'm actually gonna rename this. I'm just gonna call this firework. So with that firework renamed, I'm gonna come over here to the hold first frame and I'm gonna type in 40. I want this effect to take place at frame 40. So I'm gonna go ahead and double click in there, type in the number 40. And now when I hit play, you'll see that my firework takes place right at that frame 40. But you'll notice that although the firework itself isn't actually moving, the frame is because it's panning from left to right. So let's go ahead and fix that by adding this tracker information. And in order to add that tracker information, we actually need a transform. So underneath the firework, I'm going to shift space again to bring up the select tool. And I'm gonna type in XF to bring in a transform node. So I'm gonna just slide this transform node all the way down here. I'm gonna rename it track node. And in the center, I'm going to right click, connect to tracker one path position. And you'll notice it snaps directly to the exact point that I tracked earlier. Obviously, we don't want it there. We want it to be wherever we want it, but we want it to use that tracker information. So we need an offset. Now, I could use an offset modifier, but I find that it's a lot easier just to bring in another transform node. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring in another transform node. It's already selected. I'm just gonna go ahead and hit the enter key. This node I'm going to rename and call offset because I'm going to use this to offset the position. So I can go ahead and move this up now pretty much anywhere that I want. And I'm actually going to size it down just a little bit. Now when I play it from 40, you'll see that it stays right where it's supposed to, right above this building. So it's very close to the actual area that we tracked earlier. Now the closer it is to that area, the more realistic it will actually look, because the farther away it gets, you're going to start noticing some parallax. Now it might not be as noticeable because it's in the air and everything is nighttime, so it's dark, but trust me, if you were doing this on a building or something else where you could see everything, then it would be very noticeable. All right, so the last thing that we need to do is we actually want to color correct it to change the color. In order to do that, I'm gonna bring in a color corrector node. So again, shift space, type in CC to bring in a color corrector and hit enter. Now, as we explained in the last video, in order to actually color correct something that has alpha channel information, we're gonna need to come to this third tab and check this pre-divide post multiply. That will allow us to use the actual mask information to affect the color corrector and not the entire clip. So with that selected, I can come in here and I can simply change the color. Maybe I wanna change it to a green. And now you'll see that we have a pretty cool looking green firework, and it looks pretty cool. And you can add glows or you can add anything else you want to it. And if you want to duplicate that, the easiest way is to just come in here, Command C, Command V, everything except for the merge node, and then just grab the end of the track node and drop it into the output of the merge, and that will merge it in. If you want to change the timing, maybe come to frame 120, type in frame 120 on the hold first frame, come into the offset. We're going to have to move that offset because we don't want to use the exact same position as the last one. So if you can come into the offset, maybe we put it over here somewhere, and maybe we'll size it down even further, maybe drop it down a little bit lower in the skyline, and definitely come in here and change the color, maybe something like a pink. And now you'll notice that we have yet another one that might be a little bright for as far back as it is. So we can always turn down the brightness just a little bit. And now you'll see that it's doing a pretty good job of matching all the other real fireworks that are actually in the scene. All right, so now we'll just jump back to the edit page, let it cache and take a look. All right, I think they integrate pretty well into our scene. Maybe the colors are a little bit oversaturated, but I think it looks pretty cool. All right, so that was a quick tip on how you can use particle illusion fireworks and put them in your very own night scene. Of course, it's 4th of July this Saturday. I hope everybody has a happy and safe 4th of July. And if for some reason you don't get to see any fireworks, you can just add them yourself. That's it for me. I hope you guys got something out of this video. If you like this video, make sure to like, subscribe, hit that bell notification, and I will see you guys in the next one. Thanks.